Now the numbers are decreasing, but thousands of people are waking up with still without power this morning.
At one point, there were a total of 25,000 LG&E and KU customers in the dark from last night's storms. The 40208 zip code in the southern part of the city was one of the hardest hit areas. Eric King joins us live with a look. Eric.
Hey, Monica. Yeah, let's get right in there and take a look at this tree. There's actually two big trees here. One, it pretty much V'd and split in half, and the other one is pretty much splintered right down the middle. It's on top of this truck in front yards of a number of houses here. We're on the western side of Central Avenue, just to be specific, and this is some of the most severe damage we've seen. There's actually trees down all over the place, according to MetroSafe, and also a number of power lines down, which is why about 7,000 people right now are waking up without power. That, of course, the scene from last evening as these storms rolled through. The video was shot over at Churchill Downs, a place that certainly had its issues with weather over the past number of days. Keep in mind, they've redone their entire racing schedule over the past number of days just because of the triple-digit heat. So this is one of those situations where a lot of people there are saying, well, now we've got storms on top of that. What else can we take?
Oh, I can handle it because I don't care. I just want to be at Churchill Downs at this time. I love Churchill Downs. This is the greatest racetrack in the whole world.
We started with weather, on a hailstorm on opening night. 6 days later, we had the first evacuation of the infield due to a severe weather threat. And now we have the extreme heat. So weather was a big storyline of the meet.
So back out here live, you've got some traffic driving through the shot here. We point that out because that's a good thing with the level of trees that have been down. I understand that this road had some difficulties with traffic getting through a bit earlier. We will tell you again, there's about 7,000 people without power, LG&E and KU customers. Jefferson County taking the brunt of that. 40208, which is the Churchill Downs, Algonquin Park kind of area, is about a fourth of those outages. So crews are out working. Not specifically within my eye line, but if you go to that website, the LG&E and KU website, and click on the outage map, they'll give you some sort of indication when they believe power is going to be restored to your area. So you got a great resource tool there. Guys, back to you.
Thanks so much, Eric. Time now, 6:05, and viewers have been uploading their storm photos to ULocal on WLKY.com. Check out this hail from North Vernon, Indiana, compared to the size of a golf ball. Here is another shot of the hail that fell in the area. This picture was uploaded by Sarah Cole. And check out this tree that took out power lines on Central Avenue in Louisville. You can upload your own storm image photos. All you have to do is go to ULocal at WLKY.com.